Hi, I'm Dr. Reena Vaghasia, third year radiology resident from NHN Medical College, Ahmedabad. Today I'm presenting paper on role of MRI in evaluation of tuberculosis with its comparison with CT. Aims and objectives: evaluate the role of MRI in evaluation of the tuberculosis of spine as an investigative modality in its document its value in early diagnosis. To identify sensitivity and specificity of MRIs compared to CT, studying the MR appearance of TB spine encountered in our hospital. Introduction. TB of spine is one of the most common infection of the spine in developing countries. The morbidity and mortality rate due to spinal TB is higher. Tuberculosis of spine is caused by Mycobacterium tuberculosis. It affects the various part of the spine like vertebrae, intervertebral disc, paraspinal soft tissue, epidural space, and nerve roots. Usually two continuous vertebrae are involved, but several vertebrae may be affected. Skip lesion, solitary vertebral involvement may also be seen. Various diagnostic investigation like CBC, ESR, Montaux, ELISA, PCR are done for diagnosing the TB. We can do culture, antibiotic sensitivity, and histopath. CT and MRI frequently use imaging modalities in evaluating spinal infection. MRI provides more exact anatomic localization of vertebral and paravertebral lesion in multiple planes. Its extent on theca, quad, and foramen, while CT is useful to evaluate bony destruction. Materials and method. Retrospective study on 25 patients with the tuberculosis of spine from June 2019 to March 2021. Diagnosis was established on the basis of at least one of the following criteria: histopath evidence of caseating granuloma, histopathy demonstration of acid pass bacilli within the lesion, growth of Mycobacterium on culture of tissue, satisfactory therapeutic response to chemotherapy in patient with the clinical or radiological evidence of spine TB. CT and MRI spine was carried out in all the patient and feature were compared. Inclusion criteria: 18 to 55 year of age of patient were included. Patient presenting with chronic back pain who are not responding to conventional symptomatic management, deformity like angulation, gibbous, permanent neurological deformities like Port's paraplegia. All patients have imaging features of TB spine on CT and MR. Patient of primary pulmonary or extrapulmonary tuberculosis with spinal involvement. Exclusion criteria: patient who have imaging feature of pyogenic spondylitis on CT and MR. Patient whose laboratory workup for Cox came out to be negative. Here is an age and sex-wise distribution. The study showed that majority of the patients were female as compared to male. Most common age group was 21 to 30 year, followed by 31 to 40. Most common clinical feature is back pain followed by deformity, with most patient being afebrile at the time of presentation. The paradiscal type of vertebral lesion is most common, followed by central, anterior subligamentous, and rarely it involves the posterior elements. This study shows that the most common vertebrae involved is the dorsal, followed by lumbar and cervical, with sacral vertebrae being the least involved. This is a comparison between the MR and CT findings of the various patients. The case of a 19-year-old female patient with the lower back pain since 3 months. MRI spine study show abnormal star hyperintensity involving sacrum on both sides and left iliac wing with the hyperintense collection on the left side of the sacrum. On CT, only light erosion is appreciated on left side of the sacrum. On MR axial contrast imaging, we can see that there is a involvement spread along the nerve roots. In T1 contrast sagittal image, there is a peripheral enhancing collection abscess noted in the presacral region extending in the epidural space, which is not appreciated well on CT. This is another case of 25-year-old female patient admitted for COVID-19 pneumonia. After a few days, she developed back pain and MRI was done. Abnormal due to hyperintensity collection was noted along the right posterolateral aspect of the spine, and the epidural collection extending into right paraspinal region. The CT was normal, and follow-up scan after 3 months of AKT, significant improvement was noted. In star sagittal image, there is abnormal hyperintensity in same patient at the D6 vertebral level, which is not appreciated on CT. This is another 29-year-old female patient with a complaint of neck rigidity and pain. The contrast coronal images, we can see there is a collection in the right paraspinal region, the C1 and C2 vertebral level. CT coronal reconstructed bone window image shows light destruction of the right occipital condyle and C1 vertebrae on right side. Is on axial images, there is a exact extent of the lesion is better appreciated on MR. However, bony erosion was better appreciated on CT. another patient, coronal contrast T1 and CT images. We can see there is a collection in the left supraclavicular region, which is extending in the spinal canal through the neural foramina. We can see here the in sagittal meatus granuloma, which is also appreciated in the contrast CT. Is a axial T2 and T1 contrast and sagittal CT contrast image nodular thickening and clumping of the cauda equina novus with a diffuse enhancement and post contrast study suggestive of granulomatous arachnoiditis. This is another patient. Patient has a history of ependymoma, and then after 1 year complaint of back pain, we can see there is a anterior subligamentous collection and paravertebral involvement. There is a destruction of the vertebrae. We can appreciate it in CT. Is a gibbous deformity. TB spondylitis is defined as infection by the Mycobacterium tuberculosis involving one or more components of the spine, namely the vertebra, disc, opera, soft tissue, and the epidural space. It mostly affects the young patient. Back pain was earliest and most common symptom, usually weeks prior to the presentation. Most of the patients were afebrile at the presentation. Thoracic spine was the most common site of involvement, followed by the lumbar spine. Spinal infection is usually the result of the hematogenous seeding in the vertebral body. The most common type of involvement was the paradiscal, which occurs due to lateral spread where adjacent margin of two consecutive vertebrae are involved with a reduced disc space. The disc space narrowing is caused by a destruction of the subchondral bone with subsequent herniation of disc into vertebral body or by direct involvement of the disc. On MR, there is a T2 hyperintensity and post-contrast enhancement seen in vertebral end plate and disc. Pre- and paravertebral abscess formation seen in many patients, and sometimes it's spread in epidural space and along nerve roots, causing compression over the spinal cord and nerve roots, resulting in a post paraplegia. Second most common type was the central type, in which the infection spread along the Bartstone's plexus of the vein and involved the central portion of the single vertebrae. In anterior sublingamentous type, there is extension of abscess beneath the anterior longitudinal ligament. It begins as a restrictive lesion in the anterior margin of the vertebral body. It can also extend into the epidural space and cause compression over the spinal cord. The least common type is a posterior type of involvement. It spread via the posterior external venous plexus of the vertebral veins. Early changes in the bone marrow disc, we can identify on T2 and STAR, which is not picked up on CT. As disease progresses, the destruction of the intervertebral disc space, adjacent vertebrae, spinal enamels collapse, and anterior basing leading to characteristic angulation and gibbous deformity. There is a fragmentary and lytic sclerotic type of destruction of the vertebral enamel occur. It is important to differentiate TB spondylitis from the pyogenic. Pyogenic spondylitis involves the disc, whereas TB spondylitis usually has primary osseous involvement. Abscess in pyogenic spondylitis is thick and irregular wall, whereas in TB, it is a well-defined and thin wall. Pyogenic spondylitis tend to occur does not involve more than two vertebral body, whereas TB can involve multiple vertebral body with skip lesions. As in our study, most of the patients were young female. MRI is the best modality to avoid the radiation. MRI can very well delineate the extent of lesion without contrast. However, in CT, contrast study is required for better evaluation. Epidural spread and nerve root involvement is better evaluated on MRI. In our study, out of three patients, nerve root involvement was detected on contrast CT only in one patient. Conclusion, MRI is the best diagnostic modality and sensitive than CT, as it better determines soft tissue extent, epidural extension, bone marrow involvement, effect on theca, cord, and foramen, and therefore its effect on neural structures as well as early changes of disease. While CT is helpful mainly for assessing the bone destruction. Thank you.